Janet and Rabia.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
In this solved exercise, we are going to explain the phenomenon of self-induction. Determine the differential equation that governs the variation of the growth current. Determine the expression of the growth current. Give the expressions of the voltages across a battery and that across a resistor. Calculate the values of the electromotive force and the internal resistance of a battery, the time constant of a series RL circuit, the internal resistance and the inductance of a coil.
Consider a battery of electromotive force E and internal resistance R, a coil of inductance L and internal resistance R1, a resistor of resistance 100 ohms, two lamps C1 and C2, an oscilloscope and a switch. In order to study the role of a coil in an electric circuit, we build up the circuit of this figure. We close K, one of the two lamps gives a bright light first. Explain the phenomenon responsible for the delay in the brightness between the two lamps. Look at the circuit. C1 gives a bright light first. Why? When we close K, the current in the coil increases, then the magnitude of the magnetic field produced by the coil increases. So the coil is crossed by a variable magnetic flux. Thus, the coil becomes the seat of induced electromotive force, which, according to Lenz's law, tends to oppose the increase in the current or delays its growth. So, remember that the brightness of a lamp is related to the current it carries. Because we have a delay in the growth of the current carried by C2, then we have a delay in its brightness. Therefore, C1 gives a bright light first.
Part B. Given that R equal R1 plus R2 plus small r. I. We close the switch at time 0. I1, apply Kirchhoff's voltage law, or the law of addition of voltages, in order to determine the first order differential equation governing the variation of the current. Kirchhoff's voltage law, UAM is equal to UAB plus UBM. UAM is the voltage across the battery having an internal resistance small r, so UAM is equal to E minus RI. UAB is the voltage across the coil, and the positive sense is oriented from A to B through the coil, so UAB is equal to IR1 plus LDI by DT. UBM is the voltage across the resistor of resistance R2, and the positive sense is oriented from B to M through this resistor, so UBM is equal to I times R2. Rearrange, we get this equation. Take I as a common factor, we get another equation, but R1 plus R2 plus small r is equal to capital R. So replace R1 plus R2 plus small r by capital R, we get the differential equation that governs the variation of the current during its growth.
Let's move to the part I2. The solution of the obtained differential equation is I equals A plus B times e to the power minus t over tau, where A, B, and tau are constants. Determine the expressions of A, B, and tau in terms of L, R, and E. We will differentiate the expression of the current with respect to time, and then we will substitute this derivative into our differential equation. But first, how can we differentiate the expression of the current with respect to time? Let me remind you with this formula. Y is a function of time. It is equal to B times e to the power u. B is constant and u is a function of time. Therefore, the time derivative of y is equal to B u prime e to the power u. Therefore, di by dt is equal to 0 plus B into minus 1 over tau times e to the power minus t over tau. 0 is the derivative of the constant A with respect to time. Minus 1 over tau is u prime, and minus t over tau is u. This is going to be minus b over tau times e to the power minus t over tau. Now we will substitute the expressions of di by dt and I into our differential equation. We will get this equation. This is di by dt and this is I. Rearrange. This is going to be minus lb over tau times e to the power minus t over tau plus ar plus br e to the power minus t over tau is equal to e. B times e to the power minus t over tau is common between these two terms. So let's take b times e to the power minus t over tau as a common factor. You will get this equation. Now look at this equation. This term is constant and this term is constant. Therefore, this term must be constant. This term is only constant if minus L over tau plus R is zero, because we have here the variable function, which is the exponential function. Therefore, A R is equal to E, then A is equal to E over R, and minus L over tau plus R is equal to zero. Therefore, tau is equal to L over R.
Now, let's determine the expression of the constant B. Using initial condition, at time zero, I is equal to zero. So replace T by zero and I by zero in this equation. Then zero equal A plus B e to the power zero. Therefore, B equal minus A, and A is equal to capital E over R, proved in the previous slide. So B becomes minus E over R. I3, deduce that I equal E over R into 1 minus exponential minus T over tau. Replace A by E over R and replace B by minus E over R. Therefore, I is equal to E over R minus E over R exponential minus T over tau. Take E over R as a common factor, so I becomes E over R into 1 minus exponential minus T over tau.
Focus, please. This is important.
Let's move to the second part. Part 1a. Indicate the voltage U1 displayed on channel 1. Look at the figure. The phase of channel 1 is connected to point A, and the ground is connected to point M. Therefore, channel 1 displays UAM. Part 1b, write the expression of U1 as a function of R, small r, E, T, and tau. You know that the voltage UAM, which is equal to U1, is equal to E minus RI. In the previous slide, we found this expression of the current. So let's replace I in the expression of UAM by this expression. This is going to be E minus R E over R into 1 minus E to the power minus T over tau. Part 2a. Indicate the voltage U2 displayed on channel 2. Look at the circuit. Channel 2, the phase of channel 2 is connected to point B. And of course, the ground is connected to point M. Then channel 2 displays UBM. Part 2b. Determine the expression of U2 as a function of R, R2, E, T, and tau. The voltage UBM, which is equal to U2, is equal to plus R2I. We follow the positive sense. Again, replace the current in the expression of UBM by this expression. This is going to be R2 times E over R into 1 minus E to the power minus T over tau.
The voltages U1 and U2 are displayed on the screen of the oscilloscope. U1 corresponds to curve A and U2 corresponds to curve B. 3a. Give the values of U1 and U2 at time 0. Look at the figure. At time 0, U1 is equal to 14 volts, and at time 0, U2 is equal to 0 volt. 3b. Deduce the value of E. We proved before that U1 is equal to UAM is equal to E minus RI. But at time 0, I is equal to 0. So U1 of 0 is equal to E minus R of 0, which is equal to E. But at time 0, U1 of 0 is equal to 14 volts. Therefore, E is equal to 14 volts.
Let's move to part 4a. Use the graph in order to determine the value of tau. We will use curve B. We know that at time tau, 63% of the growth process is completed. Curve B represents the voltage across the resistor, and the curve of the voltage across the resistor is similar to that of the current. Then we can say that at time tau, U2 is equal to 0.63 U2 max. But how can we find the maximum value of U2 on the graph? This is the maximum value of U2. It is equal to 9.5 volts. Therefore, at time tau, U2 is equal to 6 volts. Look at the graph. When U2 is equal to 6 volts, T is equal to 1 millisecond. Therefore, tau is equal to 1 millisecond. Part 4b, determine the values of the internal resistance of the battery and the internal resistance of the coil. Let's start with the internal resistance of the battery. First, we must find the value of the maximum current. The value of the maximum current is given by dividing the value or the maximum value of U2 by R2. The maximum value of U2 is 9.5 volts and R2 is equal to 100 ohms. Therefore, the maximum value of the current is equal to 0.095 amperes. Now, in the steady state, the voltage across the battery is equal to E minus RI max. But how can we find graphically the voltage across the battery in the steady state? Look at the graph. The voltage across the battery in the steady state is equal to 11.5 volts. E is equal to 14 volts. The maximum value of the current is 0.095 amperes. Therefore, R is equal to 26.3 ohms.
Let's determine the value of the internal resistance R1 of the coil. We proved before that UAM is equal to IR1 plus LDI by dt plus IR2. In the steady state, I is equal to I maximum, and this current is constant, so dI by dt is equal to 0. And we calculated before that UAM is equal to 11.5 volt in the steady state. Now, replace UAM by 11.5 volt, replace I by I maximum, and replace the I by dt by 0, we get this equation. Take I maximum as a common factor. So, 11.5 is equal to I maximum into R1 plus R2. Now, replace I maximum by 0.095, calculated before, and R2 is equal to 100 ohms given at the beginning of this problem. Therefore, R1 is approximately equal to 21 ohms. Part 5. Calculate the value of L. We know that tau is equal to L over capital R, and capital R is equal to R1 plus R2 plus small r. Now, replace each physical quantity by its value. Tau is calculated graphically before and is equal to 1 millisecond, which is equal to 10 to the power minus 3 seconds. R1 is equal to 21 ohms, and small r is equal to 26.3 ohms, proved in the previous slide, and R2 is equal to 100 ohms. Therefore, L is equal to 0.147 henries, which is equal to 147 millihenries. Here, we have another method to determine the value of R1. In the previous slides, we proved that U1 is equal to E minus small r times E over R into 1 minus exponential minus T over tau. When T tends to infinity, E to the power minus T over tau tends to 0, and U1 tends to 11.5. So, replace U1 by 11.5, Replace E by 14 and R by 26.3. Therefore, R is equal to 147.3 ohms, but capital R is equal to R1 plus R2 plus small r. Now, replace capital R by 147.3, replace R2 by 100 and small r by 26.3. Therefore, R1 is equal to 21 ohms.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.